In this lecture, I am going to tell you that how we can create principal access with respect to a given configuration. So with respect to creating the principal access, there are four rules which was given by Dynamit Hartenberg. So with respect to that, the first rule states that whatever the axis creates a motion, that may be a rotational motion or the direction of motion, that should be prismatic joint. So there are two types of motion that can be performed. One is rotational motion and another is translation motion. So with the respect to this, the direction of motion be performed in such a manner. Suppose the cylinder which was cylindrical component or cylindrical motor which was placed in such a manner, so there is a shaft in between them. So whatever the axis of motion should be shown in the diagram, that should be the z axis. So with respect to this axis, this should be the z axis lies in a such a manner. Suppose if the motor is created in such a manner, or such a motor is placed in such a manner and the shaft is here, so the z axis should be in this way. So this is the first rule. And suppose if the shaft is similar and the shaft rotation shaft is up created over here, so z axis should be this manner. So the first z axis should be created in such a manner on the basis of Dynamit Hartenberg frames. The second rule states that whenever we are going to create the x axis, that x axis must be perpendicular to the present frame and also perpendicular to the previous frame. Suppose first we take the example of a single motor. Suppose this is a motor placed over here, the shaft is placed over here. So if with respect to first rule, the z axis lies over here, so the x axis must be perpendicular to this x axis. So this is the first rule for creating x axis. Another rule states that if a motor is placed over here, okay, and the shaft is pointing outward or upward, so the z axis must be this manner. But what we have to do, we cannot create the x axis in this direction, because it as per the rule, if this x axis should not be parallel to previous x axis. So in this direction we cannot create this x axis. What we can do, we can create this x axis inside the screen so that it is perpendicular to current z axis and also perpendicular to previous z axis. Okay, so this is the second rule. So in such a manner the x axis should be created. Third rule states that it must follow the right hand rule. This rule was created for creating the y axis. So suppose if there is a motor placed in such a manner and the shaft is pointing outward, so with the first rule, the z axis must be created in such a manner and the x axis should be perpendicular to this x axis, z axis. This is perpendicularness. So while putting your hand in such a way that your thumb is representing the z axis and your fingers is representing the x axis. I am drawing few fingers over here for showing you that how it is going to be created. So see, this is your thumb and this is your palm. So suppose the thumb is representing the z axis and the fingers are representing the x axis. So while placing your palm in such a manner, the line which is perpendicular to your palm representing the x axis. So in such a manner, this axis should be perpendicular to your palm. So in the same manner, while putting your finger or your palm in such a manner, you can find the y axis. So in such a manner, for a given configuration, you can create three principal axes with respect to given configuration. The fourth rule states that whenever there are two motors created, the x axis of current frame should intersect the z axis of previous frame. So for that, I am going to create a motor over here on the basis of that. the principal axis frames are created. This is z-axis, this is x-axis, and on the basis of third rule, this is y-axis pointing outward of the screen. Suppose another motor is placing over here, and the shaft is over here. So on the basis of that, the z-axis must be upward. On the basis of first rule, the x-axis should be inside the screen, and on the basis of this rule, your x-axis should be in this direction. Y-axis should be in this direction. So as per the fourth rule states that the x-axis must intersect the z-axis of previous frame. So in such a manner, you can see that when we are extending the x-axis backward and z-axis forward, you can see that the two configurations, the two links intersect with each other. So this is the fourth rule. So these are the four rules given by these two persons, that Denevit and Hardenberg, for creating principal axis frame. It is stated that the z axis should be the axis of rotation or the axis of translation. Second rule state that the x axis must be perpendicular to its both own z axis and the axis of previous frame. The third rule state that the y axis should be created on the basis of right hand thumb rule. And fourth rule states that when you are going to extend the x axis of a current frame backwards, it must intersect the z-axis of its previous frame. So on the basis of these four rules, we can create frames for a given configuration of robotic arm.